fighting the opponent you want to, since you're fighting your mandatory. What does Severn have to look forward to on Saturday?
Severn has to look forward to something that I ain't finished. This is a job that I must finish. He survived the first time. He was the only fighter to survive a knockout between me. So this is just something that I come back to and finish the job, which I will do.
Severn talks about being debilitated due to dehydration last round. Do you have any concerns for FLB?
Well, everybody has to have an excuse for something, you know what I mean?
And the thing about it is,
nobody want to hear the loser excuse. The only thing a loser can do is just say, you know, I lost. I'm going to come back stronger than ever and be that way. Because nobody cares about a loser when he lose. They don't want to hear the excuses. And Severn know damn well what happened. I beat him fair and square for 12 rounds. And that's what's going to happen the second time. This time is going to be a little bit easier. This time, because it's nothing that he have improved on. It's nothing that he's has done in the sport. He haven't even contributed nothing to the sport. The sport can live on without Severn. Severn is just like one of those little spots that just there. You can't erase a little bit. He gets smaller and smaller as the years goes on. This is the end for him right here.
There's been a lot of noise coming out of the UK for the heavyweight division. How do you plan on
I plan on doing what?
Showing them you are the true champion.
As soon as they accept the fight, that's when I show. I'm a show and tell, you know. They hiding, they throwing distractions, you know, they're making up excuses. Because I'm a risk factor. I'm a danger to anybody's career. Guys I fight, I end their careers, you know. So of course I'm a risky person to fight. That's why Hearns and Joshua, they avoiding me right now because they got a little thing going on in England. It's a money marketing thing. And they're making up all these excuses that don't have nothing to deal with the sport of boxing. Nobody cares the population. Nobody cares what money or this. People want to see fights. And at the end of the day, England is a small country. It's the size of Texas. Of course they're going to fill out things. Of course, because the areas is not far. Compared to America. America is three times the size of them. We had to travel from point A to point B. We got a lot of things going over here. Boxing is the second nature sport to them. That's nothing. That's why it looks good. It's looked good, but the reality of it, nobody cares. Only thing people care about is the best fighting the best. And that's what I've tried to do for years. I've called out the best. Every top guy in the division I've called out. Never had the opportunity. And when the opportunity presents itself, what they do? They either dodge me, go somewhere else, or they shoot up, get on PEDs. And that's the fact that come with Deontay Wilder. But after Wilder, it's coming to an end. Like I said before, Joshua got to understand he's still a black man at the end of the day. And in the UK, the slavery trade started there. So we have a mentality here. Just imagine what the mentality they have there. They're going to praise him so much, so long, until it's going to be enough. They're going to stop believing their own bullshit. And then they're going to want him to fight somebody. And then that person is going to be me. You can see when my name is mentioned to him, he don't even want to speak it. He asks the people what they want. They tell him each and every time. But they still refuse to listen. So you do the math.
Deontay, what's going to be different this fight? Are you going for a knockout? Do you need the knockout?
I don't need the knockout. Only thing I need to do in this fight, only thing I need to do in this fight is to look good. That's it. I don't need a knockout, I don't need nothing. So I'm not gonna fuck my mind around, do I need to knock him out? Because I don't. Will it look good? Yes.
Now, since you fought him last, what's changed inside you? You know, mentally, physically?
My hunger is a little bit deeper. I'm a little bit more hungrier. You know, like I said, I've been getting fucked over in boxing, you know, with all these fighters. All I wanna do is prove that I am the best. That's all I wanna do. I don't care about nothing else. I don't care about the fame. I don't care about none of that. None of that that's irrelevant to this sport when it comes to the best fighting the best. When did we start caring about the social media followers? When did we start caring about money and shit? Because at the end of the day, no money is going in nobody's pocket but the fighters and the promoters and anybody else. So why does that become a factor? The factor is the best should fight the best. In the heavyweight division, there should be one champion, one face, one name, and that's Deontay Wilder. The division is too small to have so many champions. It's too much confusion. You know, people don't even understand what's going on with the belts and this. Everybody coming up with their own opinions and stuff like that. That don't even really matter. What matters is the best need to get in with the best. I've been waiting to get in with the best for a long time. I've called them all out over and over and over again.
Do you agree with the boxing, the famous boxing quote, it's harder to stay champion than to become champion? Do you agree with that? Do you live by that?
I agree with that. Okay. I agree with that. You know, because everybody wants you. You know, it's always talent coming out of the blue.
Right.
All the time, you know. Just because we don't see them now, next year after that, you're going to hear somebody's name come up. Somebody going to be the next great, the next hot prospect. This guy going to beat this guy. You know, everybody always compare. If this style for this style, or this guy gonna beat this guy, or because he's this famous, is that, oh, he's gonna, that shit don't matter when it comes to the boxing game. The boxing game, what only matter is if this guy get in the fight, and get in the ring with this guy, and we see who the best man win. Because sometimes we may think this guy gonna win, but shit, this guy upset this guy. And then who looks stupid? The ones that believe in they bullshit, you know what I mean? So that's all I wanna do. What's wrong with that? I just wanna see who's the best, which I believe I'm the best.
Radio Raw here with Deontay Wilder. Deontay, a lot of people have been named in your mouth in the last 3 weeks. And then, just last Saturday, we had Anthony Joshua defending his title. And they said that they want you in 18. But they want you to fight somebody before you fight him. What's your reaction to that, saying that Dylan White is a necessary step for you to get to Anthony Joshua?
I'm a champion. He's a champion. I'm not going to chase nobody. I'm the American champion. We're not going to chase nobody. At the end of the day, no matter what nobody doing in their country, the mega of boxing is here in America. The money is here in America. That looks good over there. The small country with all those people, that looks good, of course. And I'm happy for what they're doing. But if you want to establish yourself, it must be here. They can sit over there all they want, but guess what? Deontay Wilder will travel anywhere. We're not trying to go to Russia. I'll go anywhere because my title said the heavyweight champion of the world, and then putting somebody. See, Dylan White is just this is just a decoy right here. This is just to stir things up. But why, Dylan White, please? That's a loud clap up for opponent. When does a champion has to go through somebody to get to that champion? Do you understand what's going on? I'm a danger factor. I'm a risk to what they got going on in England. It's just all it is. It's a big circle, and AJ is the spearman. He's the guinea pig in the middle of Eddie Hearn. Eddie Hearn, he's a spoiled brat kid that grew up with everything. He don't know what it's money before loyalty for him. He don't know what it is to come from the mud and come back up. All he sees is money. So with him, with Joshua, all he sees is money. And when it comes to me, I'm like that blockage for the money. So I'm gonna put Dylan White in front of you. Although he's a shitty fighter, he couldn't even beat a Robert Hellenius, which my man Duopa, I fought, knocked him out. He went 12 rounds and almost got beat. And I supposed to fight this man and not a guarantee to fight your man? Did y'all see what's fucking going on? Did you see what's going on? Everybody believe in the hype. The shit looks good, but the reality of it, when everybody stop becoming brainwashed, stop becoming in this imaginary mind of all that what's going on and start focusing on what's going on right here. Start focusing on their own. You know, the thing about America, we adopt so many people. We adopt so many people, and Americans here, we won't even claim our own because we adopted so many other people. When we got our talent right here, we got a black American right here with all the given ability and skills to do whatever and in anybody's career. But what we do, we go on the other side. When we got this one right here, they said, why is that though?
You're heavyweight champion of the world, the WBC green belt. That's the most sought after heavyweight championship belt in the history of boxing. He has multiple titles. You consider yourself both heavyweight champions? Are you the champion? What's the difference between you and Joshua in that regard?
Nothing's different. He's you know, even though the titles, it's still, I got the most respected belt in all of boxing, period. I don't care how many, he can have six titles. That don't make me less of a champion. I'm the champion, I'm the meanest, I'm the toughest, I'm the strongest, I hit the hardest. I'm a risk factor. If I'm not, then all these guys wanna dodge me. And, you know, the Glasgow's when it went to a Charles Martin. The Charles Martin when it sold the title to a Joshua. Everything's been given to the kid. And I'm happy for him. I'm excited for what he do because he's a black man. I'm happy for that. Because we don't get out with just dude anyway.
Other questions?
You know, but that don't make me less. That don't make him no better than me at all. Champion should fight the champion. When a champion calls another champion out, he should fight. That's what it is. It's just like, let's, like I said, I declare war. It's just like if he had a kingdom and I was on the other side of my kingdom ain't gonna say, well, if you fight these men, then you're gonna fight us. We'll get to you. And say, nah, I declare war upon your kingdom. I'm coming from America. I gotta declare war from you. So as that, as a king, you're supposed to put your arm on, you're supposed to put your crown on, you get on your horse, you come out there with your men, and you accept my challenge. AJ, do you accept my challenge?
And lastly, Tyson Fury has been all over with social media just yesterday. He says he never lost his title in the ring. He's still the true champion, and he promised to knock you out, 2 years ago or something like this, and he says he's gonna make good on that promise, knock your head off, all this kind of stuff. How do you respond to this?
First of all, you know, first you got to get in shape. That's the first step. Now, the first step, you got to get his license first. Once you get his license and get in shape, and then we'll believe anything Tyson says. You know what I mean? I would love for him to come back. I love the kid. You know, I like everything about him.
He's like him as a champion.
I respect him as a fighter, first and foremost. I respect all fighters, whether they are champions or not. You know, just because you're an up-and-coming guy doesn't mean you don't have more respect than others. If you get in that ring and fight, I respect you as well, too. It's just this right here. It takes a certain caliber of a person just to step in that ring. And that's why I don't like people calling people bums and stuff. Are you man enough to get in there? Are you man enough to fight that so-called bum? I don't think so.
Speak to that British crowd, that English audience, and says Joshua's the cash cow, as they say, and he's a heavyweight champion. How do you talk to these British fans? What is it different about them over here versus over here that they don't understand?
Listen, mate. Y'all think y'all got the best? We know we got the best. Let's put them up to the test. I've been ready. Are you guys ready? Are y'all just gonna sit around and cry? Oh, AJ, let's see who's the best. I dare y'all to test me. I'm the blockest to everything y'all want. I'm the blockest to him getting these titles. I'm the blockest to everything. You can sit over there and fill out crowds how you want. But at the end of the day, who's the best? I'm the best. I declare war. Are you up for the test?
All right, guys. Let's see. Next question. Deontay. Everybody makes a big deal out of Joshua's knockout ratio being 100%. Do you feel like he got a freebie with his last match?
Come on. Of course he did.
They could have stopped the Stavern fight with you, and you would have had 100% knockout ratio.
Of course. That could have been. If any fight should have been stopped, it should have been the Stavern fight. I beat the man to an inch of his life, like I said I would do. He had knots all over his face. He was pissing blood. He was concussed. He said he was dehydrated. But even if so, that's something to add on to the medical bill. You know what I'm saying? So he didn't even really get to enjoy his money because he had medical bills to suffer from. If any fight should have been stopped, it should have been that one.
So now
with that take-em fight, as you can see, the referee been trying to stop that fight from the fourth round on. He gave so many breaks, you know, and that's the thing about it. If any fight should have been stopped, it should have been the server. That fight should have, take-em took more dangerous punches in the earlier rounds and then the 10th round. See, what they're trying to do, they're trying to keep him squeaky clean. They're trying to keep the record clean. They're trying to keep the knockouts clean. They're trying to keep everything clean. Don't you see what's going on? It's easy. Bullshit. This bullshit. You know what I mean? Real recognize real. And I think that's what the fans have been doing. They've been seeing that this is bullshit.
Got to ask you about a quote from heavyweight legend Larry Holmes recently said that Anthony Joshua now would beat prime Mike Tyson. What do you have to say about that?
Not at all. No, he don't. Joshua don't have the confidence. He don't even have the confidence to square up against me, let alone Mike Tyson. You know what I mean? For him being British, if I would have told Lennox Lewis, I declare war upon you, Lennox would have been, let's do it. You feel me? That's the difference. I never heard a champion say he need to get ready for somebody. I need 3 years to get prepared for somebody they call fight bums, or somebody that ain't worth nothing, or somebody that don't do this and that. If I'm so easy, why do I still have my strap around my waist? If I'm so easy, why do I still talk this shit I talk and still be undefeated? It don't add up. Don't add up at all. If anybody, it's just, if any war, whether it's a street war, whether it's a boxing war, whether it's any type of war, if I declare war upon you, what you gonna do? You gonna complain? You gonna mope? You gonna come and see me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Gotta ask.
Any good questions about this fight? Any other questions about this fight?
Nobody wants to see this fight. They want AJ. That's
talk
what
about
I want.
That. Talk about why this fight's happening.
This
fight.
I mean, you got to ask the WBC why they made him the mandatory. I ain't got nothing to do with that. You know, he's my mandatory, and I must face him. That's just point blank and period. A lot of people say I haven't fought a mandatory, but why? When you talk about Deontay Wilder and you say what he haven't done, you ask yourself why. It's always a why to that point of view, to that reason. And when you see, he ain't fought nobody. Why? They all ducked me. Or they all got on PEDs. He ain't fought none of his mandatory. Why? They got on PEDs. You feel me? All that gonna circulate around to the cause of the reason. Why? I called out every name. And for all those fans that coming out from under the rock and finally trying to get on board with the heavyweight division, go back and do your research when you talk about Deontay Wilder. I am
say?
The best
last
in this
question.
Bitch.
What can they say since you agreed to fight Povetkin, you agreed to fight Lewis Ortiz?
They can't say shit, but at the
all
end of the day,
is Joshua, that's it, right?
They can't say nothing. It just come to a point where we know the fact of the matter, and the fact of the matter is Deontay Wilder is the most fear. He is the scariest guy. He do hit the hardest. But as a non-fan of his or as a fan of somebody, I don't want to admit that until the last straw, until I beat. So once I beat Joshua, just watch what happens. Watch what, you know, like I said before, they're going to praise Joshua so high until it's going to come down. If he was a David Price, they wouldn't give a fuck because he's a white guy. You feel me?